Hi, I'm Kayla Chang, author of the blog Speaking Out About Self-Injury Unhealthy Place. The relationship between self-harm and self-esteem is a complicated but undeniable one. Even in cases where low self-esteem is not the direct result of self-harm, direct cause of self-harm, people who have relatively healthy relationships with themselves don't generally think to even turn to self-harm to begin with. It takes a special kind of self-disrespect and self-destructiveness to even put the idea in a person's head. And the nuances of that can take years of therapy to parse, but we don't have years, not when it comes to self-harm. So the question is, how can we stop engaging in self-harm when we feel that the self-harm is deserved, and or that not self-harming is undeserved? And honestly, there's no right answer. It just takes a lot of mental work. You have to train yourself to look outside of and beyond yourself, both in general and in moments of crisis, in those moments where the urges are really strong. And this can mean focusing on the people around you and how your self-harm is upsetting them. It could mean finding ways of expressing yourself outwardly, such as through creative pursuits. Or it could mean putting yourself in some position of responsibility wherein you're depended on in some way, either through work or volunteering or mentorship, something like that. Reflecting on yourself and trying to work on your relationship with yourself is important, especially in the long term, but in the day-to-day, it's helpful to find ways of being in the world and engaging with the world around you, both as a distraction and as a way of building your self-esteem.